So I was basically discussing this specific configuration of the SPI protocol. So I was trying to say that the connection between SPI master, or here in this case, the microcontroller, which is of course acting as a master, and these slaves will be a bit different than this multiple independent slave configuration. So that difference is basically lies in the way these components are connected with each other. So if we carefully analyze the connection of these components, we can easily see that in this case, this single chip select is connected with all the chip selections of these individual slaves. So what it means is that this single slave, which is basically available at the microcontroller, is attached to all the chip select signals of these slaves. So what it means is that now, as soon as this signal is asserted by the master, all these slaves will become active, or basically they single signal enable all these slaves for operation. And the other important difference in the configuration is the way the data is transferred between master and slave. Because in this independent slave configuration, this data transferring signal basically independently connected to all these slaves. So principally, master can directly transfer data to any of the available or any of the connected slaves. But in this case, if we carefully analyze the connection, this MOSI is the only directly connected with the slave one. And this slave one, basically, the data output signal is connected to data input signal of the next slave. And similarly, the data output signal of this slave two will be connected to data input signal of slave three, and so on to the last n slave. So this basically scheme is basically quite different when it comes to the operation of the system. And that difference basically is, like, for example, if we have to transfer data between master and the slave somewhere in the middle, so how it will be accomplished? So initially, as we can see in this figure, the direct connection between master and slave only exists. So initially, the master jo data transfer karega, that will be available for the slave one in the beginning. And then slave one can transfer that same data to the next slave in the line, in the list, or in the queue, for example. And subsequently, this slave two can transfer the data to the next slave in the sequence, and so on. So what I am trying to say is that data cannot be transferred to any of the other slaves in this configuration, because only slave one is directly attached to the controller, to the master. So we can say the first slave who can get the data directly from the master will be the slave one. And then slave one will transfer data to the next slave in the queue. And slave two will transfer the same data to as third slave, and so on. So when it comes to time, we can easily analyze the situation is that it means the slave two will need more time to get the same amount of data that as compared to slave one. And of course, if we go much further from the master, the time basically becomes larger and larger. So the end slave will have to wait for n times the clock signals required to transfer data to the first slave. So what it means, suppose if we have 8 slaves in the system, so and we are transferring 8 bits of data between master and the slave, and if it requires 8 clock cycles to transfer the 8 bits of data between two directly connected devices, so if 8 clock cycles required for this slave one, then of course this, and there will be another 8 clock cycles required to slave the same one data to the next, and another 8 clock cycles will be required to process same data to the third slave, and so on. So what it means, 8 clock cycles will required for slave one data, and 16 clock cycles will be required for slave two, and similarly 24 clock cycles will be required for slave three, and so on. It will be multiple of 8. So in this case, we can see there will be a considerable delay in the data reception. if it basically goes to the slave which is not actually directly connected with this master. So only the first slave which is directly connected will receive the data first, and that will be the same time that we usually see in the case of independent slaves. So this is how this specific configuration works. So generally we have these two broad categories when it comes to, for example, connecting slave with the master. Okay, so now we have to proceed further to the next. There's another interesting aspect of the SPI protocol, and that is the clocking mechanism, clocking mode. In SPI, we have generally four clocking modes. Now I have to describe what it means, but before that, we have to understand two terminology, which is very important in order to understand the mode operation of the clocking. So one is the phase, and another one is the polarity. And there are two phases and there are two polarities, which we will see in the next slide with the help of the diagram, timing diagram of the signal. Okay, and this is basically the general behavior, general communication method that is established when the master or a slave has to exchange data with other device. So what it says that master and second slave must be in the same mode. So which mode? This clocking mode. Iska matlab ye hua ki master or slave jab tak same clocking mode mein nahi honge, data transfer nahi hoga. Theek hai, so this is the first step. And then during transfer with slave A and B, master must, ab ye iski puri scheme batai bhi hai, ki first step will be configuring clock to slaves A clock mode. Jis slave sath master ne communicate karna hoga, सबसे पहले मास्टर अपने आप को उसकी उस स्लेव की क्लॉकिंग मोड पे सेलेक्ट करेगा, कॉन्फ़िगर करेगा। उसके बाद वो उस स्पेसिफिक स्लेव को सेलेक्ट कर लेगा, यानी पहले अपनी इंटरनल कॉन्फ़िगरेशन करेगा, उस क्लॉक मोड पे अपने आप को कॉन्फ़िगर करेगा, जिस जो कि उस इंटेंडेड स्लेव की अंदर सेट हुई भी होगी उसका क्लॉकिंग मोड पे उसको सेट कर लेगा। देन इट विल सेलेक्ट द स्लेव, फिर स्लेव सेट होगा, यानी स्लेव सेट कैसे होगा, it will be of course by the chip select signal, jo jo us slave par available signal hota hai chip select ka, usko wo assert karega, then data transfer karega, aur fir aakhir mein usko deselect kar dega. Kyunki aapko pata hai ki SPI mein slave ke sath communication karne ka jo methodology hoti hai usme ye hota hai ki you first select the corresponding slave to establish communication. To ye ek general iska behavior hai. And once it is done with the slave A, it can proceed to slave B in the same way. Again, configuring clock to slave B's clock mode mein select karega slave B ko, uske baad phir data transfer karega aur aakhir mein isko deselect kar dega. To ye this is the procedure, this is the behavior of the master and slave communication. Acha, isme ek cheez ye hai ki master ye jo configuration karta hai apni clock ki, ye wo run time mein kar sakta hai, yani during execution when it is actually